So Kajal, Tamannaah, Parul, it's wonderful to sit down with all of you. And I'm so sorry that Manjima couldn't be here because of course she and the three of you are all in Queen. In various remakes of Queen. So first of all, tell me, how do three Bombay girls end up as the leads in you know, the various South versions of Queen?
So basically, as a maker, we had a choice to, you know, cast one girl and then dub it. Kajal is equally big in Tamil and Telugu. We easily could have just shot with her and dubbed in both the languages. But the very fact that we want the audience to connect to their very queen, you know, we want Kannada people to relate to me because they've seen me. Like, yeah. Kajal is very big in Tamil, so we want the audience to relate to Parmeshwari, and hence we thought we should make four different queens who they can relate to.
So Tamannaah, you're the queen of Telugu.
Telugu. Yeah.
Nice. But I know, I mean, I think I can say this for Kajal more than anyone else. I think she has an amazing fan following in Telugu and Tamil. I'm talking as like, I've seen your work, and I think the both of us, we've actually grown together in our career because we started off together. It's a very different feeling when you kind of start off together. And I think the kind of, I mean, I've actually seen fans go crazy about
this
her.
Tammy,
especially
Tammy,
Telugu
Tammy,
fans.
Tammy is being very modest.
No. I love it.
I mean,
are you
it.
Tammy?
I'm Tammy.
I fully call her Tammy. So you know what? She's being really modest. So there was this one event that we attended together, which was like an inauguration of a store.
Yeah.
Where was it? Do you remember?
Some interiors of Andhra Pradesh.
And we went together and people were going crazy about Tamannaah. So it's equal. It's like totally equal. And
I think
she's
very lucky. We're lucky. We've got so much love. Although we are not from the South, but yeah. I think we are from Mumbai.
Yeah.
But I think people really warmed us to us really quickly when we entered the South. And I think we both were really young.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I'm talking for the both of us. But
no,
I think I have that because I think we've known each other for way too long. And I think we're very lucky because, you know, I think being passionate about a profession is one thing, but being acknowledged by so many people and just getting that adulation and that love is something else, because I don't think you can ever plan it or you can ever decide,
sure,
this is what I want,
also,
versus any other career.
Nothing else,
yeah,
can replace it.
Yeah.
Like, no amount of money will make you feel that good.
Right.
No amount of awards will make you feel that good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like,
mm-hmm,
it's truly when you're a part of someone's home, you know, when they associate you with the basic things in their house.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, they say you want a pack of soap.
Yeah.
Or they see you on a toothpaste cover. Like, that's when you know that you're doing something right in life.
Correct.
Like, you know,
correct,
thank God, touch
correct
wood. Super grateful for everything. Super grateful for all the love.
And you, of course, are not just acting, but also producing.
Yeah.
How does that even work? That first you have four films, and then you want to act and produce.
And she's written the dialogues for the Kannada version.
I think
that's
the
amazing
additional screenplay for
the screenplay.
The Kannada version.
Yeah.
Then
and she was the set decorator for her film.
For her film.
Very multi-talented.
And then I'm also handling
she's
the
also
social
handling
media
the
and marketing.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Suddenly I feel like Rajinikanth.
Basically, she's
are you sure? She's dying.
Yeah, I'm dying. And
but how did you decide to take on so much?
I think it's the time when I saw the movie the first time in the theaters, and when I came out and I was thinking, oh my God, how lucky she is. She got to do this movie. I couldn't do it. And then that very moment, the remake occurred in my mind. And then I made a few calls to people and I said, listen, this movie is very nice. I would want to do a, you know, remake. Would you be interested? And there were some self-proclaimed advisors who said, no, Parul, it'll be a cardinal mistake to do this remake. Because there's a perception that if... Okay, I would not say all four, but few still people are like, if you do a movie where the movies ran on your shoulder, maybe there are possibilities the other heroes would be a little, they'll be
wary,
a little apprehensive.
Wary of working with you.
Wary of working with you. They'll be a little apprehensive working with you. And hence he said, you should not even get there right now.
So sorry, meaning that if this movie you do, they'll be apprehensive of working in this film? Or if you become a
woman
who can carry a film
on your
shoulders,
then
no,
they will be, yes. Yeah.
So then you might not get more work.
Yeah,
I think
exactly.
What she's talking about could have been one particular person's perspective, but
sure,
on a larger scale, I don't think in the South it works. Like, I mean, I'm
right,
sorry, I'm just again taking like,
huh,
generalizing it
no,
and saying
still,
all the four,
yeah,
languages, because
huh,
I feel like essentially times are really changing, and it's changing everywhere.
Sure.
In fact, so much of Telugu cinema is making us really, really proud, and so much of Tamil cinema is making us really proud. And Malayalam cinema has always been known to kind of make films which are really, really intelligent
and superior and content.
Yeah. I think now it's about. But I think I'm sure, you know, when we are making certain decisions, we get influenced, or people around us might say certain things.
Right.
But essentially, I think she, of course, followed her heart. And
but so I'm glad you didn't listen to that, Mr.
Obviously,
Advisor.
I did not take him seriously at all. So then he said, you should not be doing. And obviously, I didn't listen. I went on doing this. And then I helped a person from Tamil Nadu buy this right. And then he said he's going to cast me for Kannada. And hence, he then said he'll go cast one girl. Hmm. Okay, let me say Nayanthara. And he said he'll make it, he'll dub it in Telugu and Tamil. Hmm. And then nothing happened. He was hatching it for a year. And then I realized now nothing's going to happen. That's when our producer Manukumaran stepped in and he said, I will not make this movie with one girl, but I would make it with four girls and I will shoot it simultaneously. Amazing. I think it was his brainchild, and I feel the entire team of Median, which is the production house name, I think they're feminist somewhere. I think to back such movie, which is, you know, women centric, we know that women don't sell on celluloid that easily.
Yeah. I don't think that's true though. Like, I'm sorry, I have to beg to differ, you know, because I feel like largely today films, all like for me, for example, like one of the only films I saw last year was Razi.
Yeah.
I mean, I as an audience today, I'm excited because I see Alia on screen. I'm
broken.
Like,
broken, but
yeah,
not
it's even
now.
In the south. It's even in the south.
I mean, today, it's happening, today we but all not here. No, it's
but
just
no, that's untrue. You know, Anushka Shetty is such a huge star. Yeah. Thereafter, yeah. I mean, so before Bahubali also, she was a very, very, very strong star. And even after Bahubali, she's been a very, very strong star. So I think that's untrue. You know. I mean,
but
because
it's still
I have been
I guess that's what you're saying.
Yeah.
It is
not
still.
Really, not
no,
really. Just,
that's
just,
wonderful.
I think I'm very proud of the fact that South films today, people look at it, okay, they are thinking of remaking those films.
Yeah.
So, you know, I think we are creating.
They
really
are remade
content.
All the time.
No, so if you see a ratio, if there are 10 movies happening of, you know, male centric movie, then there are, you know, the ratio is just like two movies happening
a year.
Of
course.
So that is what I'm talking. I'm not saying it's not happening at all, but it's not comparatively as like the male.
But I think that is, I think, a subject that all over the world with
tell
everything.
Tell me 10 movies which were made on women centric movie last year, and tell me, I can count like 20 movies about, you know, male-centric movie.
Well, every movie is male-centric. It's almost a given.
It's almost a given. So I think that's too general.
But tell me, once you decided to do this four films simultaneously, what are the logistics of this? Like, do you go to one location and then it's 1, 2, 3, 4? Or are you in four separate locations and it's 1, 2, 3, 4? Like, how
so
does
we
it
started
work?
Our shoot in France in a small village, Nice. And then it was just like in vicinity of like 1 kilometer. Tammy was shooting, Kajal was shooting, I was shooting.
But different scenes.
Different scenes, yeah. But me and Kajal had the same director. So it is like Kajal would give one take and then after she's done, then I would go and give
same,
my
so
same
you
scene.
In the same location?
Yeah, same location. But Kajal and...
We shot simultaneously. While the others were around. In the same vicinity.
Same vicinity. So we would just
lunch,
cross
like
each other and say, hey, I'm done with the scene. I'm going for a change. We'll meet up for lunch.
So, you know, the lunch area was common. Then we'd stay in the same hotel.
Right.
Then we'd probably hang out in the evenings. Things like that. I mean, only if we had time, because most of the time we were shooting day and night.
Yeah.
So it really depends.
But that's amazing. I mean, like, just to think of the logistics of that, right? Like, I mean, it's hard enough to shoot one film.
That was challenging. Logistics is the most challenging part.
Absolutely.
You know?
How and did lines ever get mixed up? Did costumes go from one place to another?
Every film had their own unit.
Yeah,
very
it was
specific.
Still like shooting a single film.
And like everything was quite film specific.
Right.
So that was okay. We didn't have an overlap of teams. We didn't have an overlap of anything. Parul and I still had a few overlaps because our director was an overlap, obviously.
Right.
But it was still very comfortable in the sense like I'd come, she'd go, she'd come, I'd go. So we were not in each other's face. It was quite comfortable. And we had that understanding as actors to allow each one to be. You know, you don't want to stand there and try and make... At the end of the day, if an actor is staring at you while you're performing right in front of the camera, it's not... It's
I'm
kind of
conscious
it's
of
like
this thing when she was giving her take, me being a co-producer, I had to be there on the set.
Correct.
But when she would give her take, I would turn my back or I would just move away for the very fact that I won't have to feel comfortable and I also don't want to get influenced by her
by
take on the
I was going to say,
know?
So what does this simultaneous four versions do to an actor's performance? So of course there's the original,
correct.
Right? So there's Kangana's version of it. First of all, did you guys watch that to see what to take,
it.
What not to take?
Times.
Really?
I've seen it a lot, but I mainly saw it to get the moments that were so, so amazing that I didn't want to miss out in my version. And my version is essentially is like the original. We've stuck to the original.
Frame to frame.
Maybe not frame to frame, but largely in scene to scene. Like right. The main content scenes are pretty much the same.
Okay.
But I think what was the challenge was to Teluguize it, because that's the reason we are making these films in four different languages, is to stick to nativity, because the emotion, being a universal emotion, still needs to be made into, like, for me, my character's from Rajahmundry, so I spoke the slang that is, so Telugu also has various slangs, just like Hindi spoken various different ways. Similarly, Telugu has various different slangs. So we chose Rajahmundry as our place, and then I was supposed to speak the slang. And so Telugu also, not just adding the language aspect to it, but the cultural aspect to it. So our challenge was to make this like the original in terms of emotion.
But local. Right. And did you guys find each other a distraction or a support when you were working?
I think largely a support, actually, if I can say that. More a support, less of a... Because I think we went through similar...
life journeys, in a way.
Yeah, but even similar issues on set, if we had any. Yeah, it was always like we had similar confusions or similar stuff, you
so
know,
would you
discuss.
Go to Miss Producer here and say
she was the most the most hands-on.
She was actually the most approachable, but we did not want to,
because she also was acting and performing.
Way, because
you know?
She's also an actor.
Yeah. Correct.
You know? So you can't complicate the lines. So we did not really go to her with any issues as such. We deal with Manu, who was like our producer.
Our producer,
So let's do South India languages for North Indian dummies like me. Like, what is one thing you would do in Telugu that you would not do in Tamil, or perhaps do in Kannad and not do in Malayalam?
So I made mirchi mandaki, and she's made what?
Bajis.
Bajis.
I have made bajis.
And you made
dosa.
She's made dosa.
Ah.
For example, that's the nativity you get into
But in terms of actual moments or scenes, is there something that would be cool in Tamil but like totally not okay for Telugu?
Not really.
I think we all had I think everyone, each part thought a lot about the sex shop scene. I think that was one scene that we all had to decide whether to even have in the film or not.
Okay.
But I think we've come to a point now that, I mean, I think we are beyond that. And mostly, I think what I found was amazing about that scene was that it made that, the whole scene was so funny. You know,
and
but
also
I think
it shows the naivety of the character. It was pretty okay. I mean, you did not want to...
It was really cool to have it there.
You didn't want to cut it. And plus, it's coming of age. I mean, you would talk about stuff. I mean.
No, also the subject is so universal. I'm sure everybody can relate it. It's not like that it's region-based. It's just so very universal.
But I think to answer your question, it was primarily to just like she said, it's probably food and like small things.
It's nothing major.
Nothing of the movie stays the same. But there are some, like as I said, bajji, and she would make some dosas, that sort of a little here and
okay,
there.
Okay, I'll tell you one small example. So in Telugu, the girl, Ammai, okay, that's what she's called. The girl is called an Ammai, and she would wear a red bindi. Red or traditionally black, tiny dot on her forehead, okay? But in Tamil, the Punna, as she's called, will wear a white vibhuti.
Yeah. So like small, very small.
Tiny little nuances.
Right.
But they make a difference. That's like a cultural thing.
And did you guys, as three actors, sort of want to flesh out this character to suit your personalities in any way? Did you all add to it?
So we did it on a very personal level, because obviously we did not want to, I mean, not like we discussed it with one another, but we did it at a very personal level. So I saw Queen just like when it released in 2013, and I loved it. I remember falling in love with Kangana, her film, the character, everything about it.
Yeah.
When I was offered this film, I consciously steered clear from watching it again, because I did not want to get influenced A, by her, and B, I did not want to get influenced by the other girls. Like, I wanted to make sure that it's mine and I can contribute to it and adapt it according to how I am personally, bring in my emotions, bring in, be as real and as authentic as I possibly can on screen. Also, really feel it. Like, I wanted to actually feel it. And of course, this sort of a story is so relatable for everybody across different jobs, across age groups, across what they do. Everyone in life goes through similar experiences. And that's what normal growing up and the whole process of evolution and metamorphosizing is all about.
Yeah.
So I guess that's what it was for me. I wanted to focus on my journey with the character and just keep it as personal as possible. Just keep it real and honest.
Because there's so many versions, right? Yeah. There is the original, then there's each one.
For me, I think it took me about 3 months to get into the head of this character. I remember that I had sleepless nights. I was thinking that, you know, I have said this earlier, but when a girl is too naive, you know, anybody is very naive, they come across as stupid.
Right.
You know, and that is how Kangana has actually played it, you know. And if you see the whole sex shop, that she's so naive that she's like stupid.
Yeah, yeah.
She's like a butt of joke. So I was like thinking in my head, if I do that, people will think I'm going to imitate. And then what I do, what she's done and how different I can do. So I think it was just like my 10 days of workshop, what I got into, and my 5 days of workshop basically to get to the entire that timid body language, because I'm from Bombay, I have a very confident body language. What I understand of this character, that she's quite a timid, you know. Mm-hmm. So I think that took me 15 days, but it was one fine day when I was traveling from Goa airport to Gokarna, where I was shooting the other day. So that time I was just thinking, what do I do? And I was just discussing with my team, and Manu Kumaran happened to be there in the car. I was like, how do I play this character? I'm still not able to crack this thing, you know. And then he said, why do you want to play stupid? You could just play so sweet that people just want to fall in love. And I said, yeah, that's right. I could just play it so sweet, you know. And that is how I
that's what you did.
Did in the movie, yes. Yeah.
But tell me, of course, you said in the beginning that you want each region to have their queen, right? Yeah. But like you also said, like the two of them can be in a Tamil movie, can be in a Telugu movie. You've also done many languages.
Yeah, but I can't do Tamil and Telugu like them. I'm just known in Kannada industry.
No, but how did you decide who does what?
Okay.
Like, did you guys have to choose? Did you get to choose?
No.
No? You just said, this is what you're doing.
No, not like that. I mean, we did not go. We went
See,
with a Tamil movie
for
to
me,
her. And
yeah, I think it was just, they just approached us for the given languages. And clearly, we both do both languages.
Correct.
So,
so how do you choose? Or do you both like?
I think I don't know. I can talk for myself on this, but I choose on film base. I don't actually choose it according to language. Language has never been the mainstay in anything. Language is just a way to communicate something to a certain kind of audience who speaks, because it's their preference.
Yeah.
But having said that, that was the only reason why I would choose one. A script is a script and a film is a film. So it's chosen on its merit of whether I like it as a subject.
Whether it's fun.
And I treated this as a straight Tamil film. I did not treat it as four films.
But right.
I mean, I ensured that I'm quite spontaneous about my choices vis-a-vis this film.
Hmm. But I also, I've said this earlier again, saying that I actually complimented both of them. In fact, all the three of, okay, I'm going to include myself also.
All four of us.
That, I hope you guys don't mind. Before we signed on Kajal or Tammy or Manjima, we had approached other actresses as well. And a lot of actresses said, oh, it's a beautiful movie. Oh, she got national award, blah, blue. We believe in the subject, but sorry, no, we don't want to do it. Because they had their own fear that media would compare them to Kangana, or the audiences might not like, because this character is so loved.
Yeah.
Next to impossible to actually, you know, make them fall in love with what you have actually conceived.
Correct.
So I think she took that challenge, every one of us just took that head on. Mm. And I'm sure that this crossed my mind that I'm not going to only get compared with Kangana, but rest of the three, and all of them are brilliant actors.
Of course, it's crossed our minds as well,
Yeah, for sure.
I remember calling up Tamannaah before we boarded the flight to the south of France, and I was like,
back off, Kare?
No, it was too late to back off by now. I called her and I was like, Asha, what time is your flight? Okay, the Mehndi Wali left from your house, when is she coming
like
to my
discussing
house?
Stuff like this.
We were discussing Mehndi Wali.
Like, shaadi karne
and the Mehndi Wali comes and says, no, maine Tamannaah ke haath mein aisa lagaya design. I said, toh fir aap please mere haath mein waisa mat lagaiye. Kuch aur kijiye. So, things like that, you know.
No, we had like some healthy exchanges. Like for Hazi, she said we were traveling together. So I met her at the airport, and she said, Parul, mehndi ki cone le liye. So I was like, no. She's like, ye fade ho jayega, and we have a schedule of 40 days. I'm like, oh yeah, shit, I did not actually.
Right.
Then she said, okay, don't worry, I have the cone, you can borrow it from me. Similarly, when I was sitting with Kajal and we were discussing together, and I said, Kajal, just make sure when you're sitting on dubbing, that ask that lady to have a little South Indian accent to her English.
Right.
So I think we all had that kind
you
of
all helped each other.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely.
And there was good camaraderie, so we really did not have any sort of competition as such.
Nice is such a small place. I'm just thinking, the locals must have been like, what is going on here?
Why are they all in similar clothing? Like, what is it? Is it
like four girls dressed as nerds?
Yeah.
So bizarre. And why are they all?
But the media was there to cover us. What are these four girls doing here?
Right. That must have been so funny. So tell me, just about this move for three Mumbai women. Who are now so established in South industries. You know, how tough is it? We were talking before we started recording about how she's learned the language, and just in terms of sensibilities, what what is the biggest challenge that you guys have faced?
So for me, moving to, well, not moving, starting my life actually, more than 10 years ago, it's been almost a decade, was very serendipitous in a way. I did not quite understand what I'm doing at that point of time, nor did I preconceive it. It's not like I tried for anything. It just, thankfully, touch wood, I cannot be more grateful, but it just happened.
Sure.
And, well, at that point of time, I remember my first film, it was a Telugu film called Lakshmi Kalyanam, which means Lakshmi's wedding. And I was shooting in this town called Madanapalli, okay, which is like in the interiors. It's on the Karnataka Andhra Pradesh border. Really tiny little village. I was shooting there, and this was straight out of college. And I was working in a multinational company. Like, my internship was in a multinational company where I was, you know, tick-tocking up and down the lobbies in like really high stilettos. And from there to wear a half sari and to live a village life, which I had never done before, was a culture shock for me. I had no idea about South Indian cinema. I had never heard of South Indian directors. I had never watched a South Indian film in my life. So for me, I was like, what exactly am I doing? Then I thought, okay, maybe I'll just do one film so it sounds cool on my CV, and then bounce to like NCR
University. So much for one film.
Exactly. Bounce, go
10 years later.
So that's what I had visualized for myself. I remember finding the language difficult. I remember finding the body language difficult. My director used to say, you walk like a man. Can you please be more feminine?
I think we all got that at some point.
Really?
Yeah. He's like, Kajal, you're not wearing jeans.
Film walking is very different than...
You need to be feminine.
Yeah.
So, and I am a very tomboyish sort of a person. So for me to... And also I'm really enthusiastic. So to calm down, like curb my enthusiasm, and to be like very poised was quite a challenge, you know? So I remember having such kind of challenges. Like, I really had to learn my way around. I really had to like work hard on myself, work hard on my speech, work hard on my body language, work hard on my mannerisms. You know, you can't act like one Bombay brat. You need to, you're a film actor. So I had to really learn all of that. And plus I had no point of reference. Like, nobody I know in my peripheral, in my close core circles or even distant circles is from the film fraternity.
Yeah.
So for me, it was really difficult to kind of adapt to all of that. But well, I'm super happy with the way things have turned out, and I'm super happy that we've done Paris Paris, remake of Queen, and in each language, each one of us. And it's just great. It's been a great journey.
I've
what
had
about
actually,
you? How did you learn film walking?
Okay, like film walking.
What is film walking? First, explain that to me.
Actually, it's what how models
no,
do
it
as
has
well.
To show it.
I mean, I guess she does the same thing, but it's okay. Like, if this is your left leg, right? Left leg and then the right leg.
Achha, matlab latak matak ke chalna.
And then automatically the rest of the body moves on its own.
Got it.
Yeah.
Well, I think if I have to just make everything very short and sweet, you can call me a Bhelpuri because I'm a foodie and I think everything in terms of food. But I started my career very young. I was 15. So I got used to whatever came my way. And I did not have any ideas or, like she said, preconceived notions about anything. And I just wanted to be an actor. And 15 years after, I have just become, I'm as much a Mumbaiite as I am a South Indian.
Yeah,
I am as much pav bhaji as I am dosa.
Which is great.
That's why I eat dosa and pav bhaji together, just so that I feel like I'm both of it.
Weird
you
concoction.
Do that?
Very weird concoction.
But I think it tastes really good. I don't know why I've explained my own self in terms of food, but I think this is the most accurate way of putting it.
Oh, yeah?
That's amazing. I'm really proud of your analogy.
Yes.
But in you do get pav bhaji dosa in many places.
I
don't
know that.
Yes. I eat it all
that.
The time.
Yeah. No, no, hello. You're saying that you get a dosa on one side and a pav bhaji on
the
other?
Together.
Like peanut butter.
On the
so
dosa?
There's a dosa and uske upar there's pav bhaji.
I think they give it to you on your preference if you like it outside or inside.
That's who you are.
The point is, I'm pav bhaji dosa.
So for me, nothing else, this kind of thing has occurred. But for me, it took me a little while to understand that if you want people to love you, your audiences, I think you have to learn the language. I think that is what I've learned. It's not that what you speak on camera and camera is on or who dubs and all, but when you go out there and then you speak to your fans or when you are you know addressing the media, it's very very important to know the language where you're working. I think that is what I've learned, and I learned a little late, which I regret, But that is only the time when people are really going to relate to you.
So this
is what I have learned.
I respect your point of view, but I have a little different stand on this particular thing. Yes, learning the language is extremely important for...
And you speak Telugu now.
I speak Telugu, yes. I'm not very fluent with Tamil. I understand Tamil, but I can't converse in Tamil very well. It's very puta-puta. But what I feel is that... But I'm also more conscious. Like, I hesitate. Because I feel like I may mess up and I'm afraid to do that.
Right.
So, weird barrier I have in my head. But my point was that, yes, it is important to know the language, but that's more about the effort you're putting in, you know, because you want to kind of give back to the people who've given you so much.
Yeah.
And you want to kind of reciprocate the love and reciprocate the, you know, you want to do your bit.
Mm.
But people, I feel their love is not only dependent on whether you can speak in their language or no. It's more about your honesty, your authenticity, which kind of shows through. You can't really have.
I remember a big hero called Dr. Rajkumar.
Yeah, yeah.
I think you might know.
Yeah.
So he had said in Kannada, "Abhimani galu devare galu," means your fan is your god.
Right.
So I feel, I felt they would write on my social media that why don't you speak in your language.
Correct.
So I think if they give me so much of love, I feel like in return at least I can make an effort to learn the language.
Of course.
And even if you make mistakes on camera, I had my own share of those moments where I have said wrong things.
Even until they speak wrong.
Yeah, but then they're okay with it. They're okay making you mistake, but they're not okay you not taking effort. You know, so that
correct.
Is what I feel.
Exactly.
No, I just feel like as an actor, it's always an edge. Like I speak Tamil and Telugu and I just, I mean, I remember how I used to practice my language skills was in a press meet.
Really?
I said, I can't be more scared of anything than a press meet, right?
Yeah.
With like so much media.
Huh.
And I have to speak, so let me just, let me practice on them.
Huh.
So I would go out, start talking in some Telugu I thought was right. But I also had a makeup artist who spoke Telugu, so he would teach me.
Oh, that was a deliberate attempt.
I was like, let me practice because this is as scared as I can get.
Yeah, exactly.
I can't.
Yeah.
Did
you make any major faux pas?
So only my co-star noticed it because I was wearing a dress and I'm talking with utter confidence in my Telugu or Tamil. It was Tamil.
Huh.
In utter confidence, like head up. If you see the frame, I'm like fierce,
huh.
But my legs are
trembling.
and Karthi. So he was like, why are your feet trembling? I came back, I said, because I was scared. But you know, I guess that's how I got my courage to also talk in the language.
Converse.
And now I'm like, I start talking to my driver in Mumbai in Telugu and I'm like,
you know, but that happens.
And I'm like, why isn't he getting it? And I'm like, oh shit, I'm in Mumbai.
That happens to me all the time. So I'm talking to the staff at home and suddenly I'll break out into Telugu.
Right.
Like certain words. So if I want to say something and, or maybe if I'm trying to talk in Marathi to the taxi driver, suddenly Telugu words pop into my head.
Right.
And I'm like, okay, no, Marathi, focus.
But that's great. I mean, that's so wonderful to know another language and another culture and to be able to connect.
You know, I think I know it better than my own.
Really?
Like, I know Telugu Tamil weddings better than Punjabi weddings.
Huh.
I know the culture.
So many times
you've
gone married on
exactly. The way they celebrate things, I know, I understand that far better. And
right.
I feel like my heart is full South Indian.
Really?
Full South Indian.
That's so sweet. But tell me, just in terms of... sort of cultural differences, you know, within the film business. And you know, the cliches in Mumbai is always, South is more efficient, they will shoot this much and we will shoot this much and it's very organized. And of course, the fan culture is at another level because there's organized, especially in Tamil Nadu, there's organized fan clubs. Is there?
In Andhra.
Even Andhra. All over, is
all
it? So are there massive cultural differences since you go between so many industries?
I don't think so. I think both the industries are equally, professional. So I really do not think that, you know, they are more organized. Both the industries are organized. Yes, talking about fans, there are some crazy fans, you know. Like
I think they are loyalists.
They're very loyal. The South Indian fans are definitely way more loyal than in the North.
Yeah.
But I think also because movie going is not about just entertainment there. It's something that...
Worshipping.
They worship.
No, I wouldn't call it worship. I just think it's a part of their life.
They
cannot
do
the family.
Yeah,
for them,
it's
movies
a
is beyond
so your Friday, Saturday,
entertainment.
Are guaranteed.
So I guess that's why the adaptation is a lot more, you know,
but the
long term.
Is that also more frightening because there's such a loyalty?
Definitely. Definitely, you can't.
I feel really
guilty when you are not able to. Like there are times I'm not able to respond to my digital fans. People who, and I know them by name actually, I know them by their account because I follow what they do for me, and I have to say this on this show because it will be I think they will feel really happy about it. But on my birthday, there was a cake shaped, like something that looks like a cake, a card which opened and blossomed up into this table-sized flower. I think that is the most beautiful birthday gift I've ever got, and I could not post about it. I couldn't talk about it. Only because I was at that point of time extremely busy. Yeah. And I, trust me, I actually feel guilty about it. I feel guilty about not being able to post about it.
Right.
Because they put in so much, and there's a like literally like a love letter inside with everyone's names. I got to see the letter, so that's how I know. But it's been on my mind, and I was like, I have to somehow speak it out. And I'm glad I got to do it on your show, because I think they will be so happy, because they genuinely love you the way you would love, I don't know, whether you can say your lover or, you know, your mother or something as pure as that.
But is that also for an actor constricting? Because can you then take a complete leap of faith, do something really dark and edgy, and or something that they don't expect to see you in? Can you do that?
I feel it's constructive and destructive at the same time. I think having so much of fans is really good. But at the same time, now I'm sometimes very cautious that what I should put out on social media, because I feel a lot of my fans wouldn't like it.
But like what? Like what's one thing that they wouldn't like?
Okay, for example, like I was in Miami and I wanted to post my bikini picture, but I just held back. I said, no, I cannot do that.
Really?
I really did not.
I don't know. I personally feel like I am also... I think I'm largely who I am. I'm not someone who has a problem about putting out something that I'm not, because I'm also generally a very chilled person. I'm very work oriented. I don't have a life that is something that people don't see, and you know, I don't have that kind of a life. People who know me, people who work with me, people who are my friends, generally know I'm very, for lack of better words, chilled, or you know, causes what you might like, what she might consider like, you know, something that fans would not like.
So you're saying Tamannaah actually on this.
There's no self-censorship then.
No, I'll tell you what. I have a sense of responsibility, which I've always been. It's not got to do with being in the movies. I think if I was, if I was not an actor also, I think I have a certain sense of responsibility which works for anything public. See, in my house, what I do, I'm not answerable to anybody except my parents, because I'm very close to my parents and I'm answerable to them. But after my parents, I'm not really answerable to anybody. And I don't feel like putting out my life all the time. I don't think it's required.
Yeah.
But if I like something, I'm very happy about something, I always share it.
But I actually put out a lot about my personal life on social media. Like I am extremely close to my family and friends, and I put pictures with them all the time. I'm always posting things about maybe things that I'm doing. I like giving my fans that little insight into what my personal life is all about. And it's not because, even I have a very strong sense of responsibility. Like I feel like if I am influencing so many young children, I do not want to be a wrong influence for them. So that is one thing that I'm conscious about. But for example, like the bikini photo, I would never put up a bikini because I'm shy. I wouldn't do it.
No, but here you're not shy and you held yourself back.
Yeah. Yeah.
But there was Kajal, so much talk about that scene from your teaser, right? Mm-hmm. From your queen thing.
Mm-hmm. I knew this was coming.
Yeah, did you expect that? I mean, wasn't that because they probably don't expect to see you or something?
So that's, you're right. You're absolutely right about that. There are... apprehensions sometimes that I face, or when I'm like, oh my god, how are people going to react to this? Oh my god, they won't be okay with this. So I spoke about this with my director. It was then the original queen as well.
Yeah.
But I was like, do not put this on the trailer. I'm not sure. I don't know how people will react. Of course, I was apprehensive about it. But then it was already done and the trailer was releasing the next day, so I could really not do anything about it. So last minute. B, I came to terms with the fact that unless you don't try something new, you're never going to really change people's mindset.
Yeah.
And if we are trying to be trendsetters in certain sort of genres, I'm not saying that everyone has to go and get groped in a particular scene. But what I'm trying to say is that this is a completely platonic, it's not done to generate...
there's a reason it's there.
Controversy.
Yeah.
It was done because it's in the, when you watch the film,
of course,
you understand in the mood of the film that it's very playful. It's between two girlfriends.
Yeah.
And it's like very, it's very funny. It's supposed to be done for the humor.
I think generally, I think today in social media, or even if you put out, oh, my favorite color is blue, people will have an opinion on why your favorite color is blue. So I think, you know, we are in a generation where whatever we do, we will get an opinion on it. So there's only so much you can care about
opinions all the time. But I'm very cautious of what I put out there, and I don't want to, you know, offend people. So yes, that's the thing.
But you know, actually, just to cut you out here, I'm not talking about social media at all.
Right, you're talking.
I'm talking generally.
Like the fans,
I'm talking about my films. So for example, I did for the first time in my life, first and last, I ever did a special number for like I did it for my friend's film,
I think it was
people
awesome.
Went crazy, like they, not crazy in a good way. They were very anti it. My fans gave me a lot of grief. They were
serious?
Like, yeah. They were so they
I
liked
love
it.
That song.
They liked it after the song released.
Okay.
But till they knew, just the news was that I'm doing a special number. They were dead against it. I got a lot
so
of.
So I'll have to say something on
feedback
that as well. Yeah. So
saying that you know you shouldn't be doing this. There's no need for you to do this. Blah
right.
blah blah.
Because you're too big to do this.
And what is the need for you to do this?
Right.
In someone else's film.
Right.
Okay. But the point was, I wanted to try it. And I actually messaged people back.
Phenomenal.
I messaged people back and I told them, listen, if you're expecting something vulgar, there isn't anything.
Yeah.
So do not, like, that was my sense of responsibility that kicked in, you know, where I was like, no, it's not that way. Just watch it.
Yeah.
So you know, when I do films, I really don't really think that what audience is going to think, but I really think what is required for the character to. For example, this movie, what I'm doing, Butterfly, in the end, if you see the character of Rani kisses the chef, she smooches him.
Yeah.
So I objected to my director. I said, I want you to take off the smooth scene. And he's like, why you're not comfortable? I said, A, I'm not comfortable. B, I don't believe that a character who's from Gokarna, who's so timid and naive, I don't think so that she'll go and just smooch a random guy, any chef.
Right.
I, being from Mumbai, I wouldn't go out and smooch any boy like this.
Yeah.
So when I can't do it, I don't think so this character who's from Gokarna would go and do it. Or hence, I took it off from the movie. But having said that, when I go on social media, I'm very cautious of I should not be offending my fans. So I'm a little careful.
So,
there.
You know, a couple of years ago, this was probably at least 4 years ago. So I love dancing, and I think a lot of my fans and people who watch my movies, a lot of my fan following has come because of the kind of dance I do.
Right.
And I'm a huge Katrina fan. Like, I think Katrina makes every party rock because all her songs are the songs that we all want to hear. We all have danced to it in our
of
own ghar ke parties. Ye wo.
Bilkul.
And I still look at her as a great inspiration from the perspective that how much strength a song has versus a film sometimes because a song can be played over and over and over again.
Repeat value.
Yeah.
Even after 10, 15 years and people will not forget that.
Absolutely.
And for me, 4 years ago, I had been offered just like her, my first item number, and I'm not being ashamed to call it an item number because I love those.
Mm.
I dance on them my own self. I've grown up dancing on them. I enjoy them in parties. I enjoy them in functions. Kisi ki bhi shaadi ho, that's what we're doing.
Right.
And when I was offered my first, I was like, hell yeah. Because people have to get this out of their head that if you're a female lead in the South, if you're going to do an item number only when your career is coming to an end because you have no better work to do.
Right.
I think that perspective was very derogatory.
Exactly. Yeah.
And I love dancing. I think if I were to be born ever again, if that even exists, I want to be born as a dancer because that's such a beautiful life. To be able to dance and to express yourself.
Yeah. Mm.
And today I'm doing these. I've not done one, but I've done at least 4 or 5 of them. I've lost count.
Wow.
And I love, you know, today, recently I went to meet some kids who were from, you know, who were not as privileged. And they were so sweet and they were from the Bastis, they were from homes. And, you know, they were like, let's dance on Swing Zara. That
sweet.
Was my item number.
Yeah.
They all wanted to dance on that. They were like, no, we don't want any other song. We want that song.
Right.
Because that song just makes them dance, makes
people
them happy.
People can resonate with it.
So
yeah.
I think,
that's
you know, that there's so
about.
Many perspectives to this thing. Everything has, I think Queen is the biggest example.
Yeah.
Every scene that in any other, in other film would be wrong is right in this film.
Absolutely.
Because it's the perspective.
Yeah.
The thing we're trying to do with films and movies is give a perspective to people. It's not right or wrong, and everything need not always be in right and wrong. It can be just a perspective, and it's beautiful to have a perspective.
I think so, and you know, I love that movie, and I'm so happy to see it traveling in so many ways.
Mm-hmm.
You know, of course, it was a big hit, but the fact that you will be seen as queens of, like you said, the various regions is just wonderful, and I hope more women see it, more men see it, and get inspiration like we all did when we
all
saw
did.
It
of course,
the first time.
Absolutely.
And when she walked away from him, we all clapped.
Of course.
So good.
Yeah, we
liberating in a way.
Absolutely. So.
Yeah, I said this in other interviews as well. I want to repeat also that the things what really appealed to me in this movies are the scene where, you know, there's a breakup scene happening and then the character Rani tells him that, you know, the hero tells him, can we reconsider this relationship?
Yeah.
And then she says, hey, listen, dude, can I talk to you later because I have to go and attend the concert. She's elevated herself so
Absolutely.
Much that man doesn't bother. So I feel in a way it's like educating men.
Yeah.
And also the fact that if you see, you know, where she's driving the car and the hero says, you know, aap gaadi nahi chala sakte, aap to bus mein jao.
Right.
And then she's like, you know, that man is playing with her confidence, you know. So similar, something has happened to me, you know, with my guy who told me that, you know, you can't drive. And then on the other hand, my mom thinks I'm the most fantabulous driver ever, and I'm the best female driver in Mumbai. And then this guy tells me, so I was in a confusion and a dilemma whether I'm a good driver, bad driver. And then when I saw the movie, I realized that men actually play with women's confidence without even knowing them. You know?
Yeah.
So I felt this story was, I mean, on a personal level, I really wanted to do it.
And you did.
Yes,
and you did. And you know, more power to all of you.
Thank you.
I hope it's
it was so lovely chatting with you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having us over.
Hi guys, if you like this video, please subscribe
to Film Companion.